It is not enough for us to just count the number of jobs that we have created. We really want to figure out, are these jobs improving lives? Because at the end of the day, that's why we exist. So to answer that question, we turn to a logic model to help us very systematically break down our intervention and think through step by step, what is the cause and effect of what we do? With any logic model, you should start with the inputs. What do you have? Or how do you think about your mission? What is your reason for existence? With those inputs in hand, what will you actually do to carry out your mission? You know, this is where you really list out the activities. Now, outputs. What happens as a direct result of those activities? This can also be thought of as outreach, those numbers we were just talking about. How many lives has your program touched, right? And this is what you have direct control over. With those outputs, we then think about outcomes. And this is where it starts to get interesting. This is the so what. What happens as a result of those outputs? You touched 1,000 lives, great. But did those lives improve? These are really the meaty questions. And these can also happen perhaps a little bit outside your direct sphere of influence. This is what happens over a longer period of time. And then lastly, as part of the logic model, we have impact. In an academic sense, to prove impact technically means you need to be able to show statistical evidence to link your action to the observed outcomes. This is where you prove that causal connection. And most of the time to do this requires undertaking a randomized control trial or some other rigorous research method. But here I want to drive home a point, and this is my opinion, of course. We mission-driven organizations should not be scared off by the intensity of an RCT or rigorous research that prevents us from measuring anything. This is not an all or nothing game. So we should not say that just because we cannot afford rigorous research that we shouldn't measure social outcomes. I feel like too many people stop at just the outputs or outreach. And what I really want to be the key takeaway of this presentation is that we can and should move to this middle ground of outcomes. And even if we don't do anything more rigorous than that to really prove impact, measuring outcomes and being very systematic about it can yield just a wealth of information and improve your models. And I will talk about how that has helped us. So here I show Upaya's version of the logic model. As I said before, we start with our mission to create dignified jobs for the poorest of the poor by investing in scalable businesses. The primary activities we undertake is a very rigorous screening and selection process. And then we put the businesses we select through a 4-month accelerator program and provide them deeper support. After the accelerator program, we will choose a handful of them that actually receive patient equity investment and then more hands-on consulting support over the next 2 or 3 years. And by doing all these activities, what we are really hoping is the immediate output are profitable, self-sustaining, and scalable enterprises. And if these businesses are all those things, they should create new jobs for the poor. And these are the things that we have some control over as Upaya, because this is how we work hands-on with our entrepreneurs. And we really advise them on how to make their systems more robust and their businesses more profitable. And so we hope that yields more jobs. But then after that, what happens is a little bit out of our control, but we certainly hope it happens because that's what our mission is. And that is, these new jobs should provide stable and increased income for job holders. And that income should move those job holders out of poverty. And we will look at how it moves job holders out of poverty along a number of dimensions. Once we have defined all the steps of our logic model, we can then define the metrics that correspond with each of these steps. And these are the quantitative measures that give us an idea of whether we are on track or not with our mission statement. For example, if we want to track whether our portfolio companies are scaling or not, we would measure quarterly revenue growth and see, does this revenue growth track to the entrepreneur's financial projections? We look at, you know, what percentage of companies in our portfolio have hit profitability? How much follow-on capital have they attracted? Are they able to meet their growth goals and keep scaling? To track progress out of poverty, we look at a number of different things. So first and foremost, we would measure the increase in income, and I'm going to talk about that a little later, and then observe what this increased income helps that person and their household do. Are they putting this new income towards improving the condition of their house? Are they able to purchase and eat more food? Are they purchasing more assets for the household or productive assets? Are they sending their children to school? We collect this information directly from the job holders and let them tell us what they are doing and how they are being helped. The more a person's income allows them to make decisions about their well-being and their aspirations, the greater progress they will make out of poverty. So we try and capture, like I said, directly from them, what they claim these jobs are helping them do.